This is Match Game 74, production number 0154. Air date to be announced, VTR 2274, and it's... take one. Get ready to match the stars. Larry Blythe. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Riley. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Kay Stevens. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Good. I guess they are raring to go. Thank you for joining us here on Match Game 74. And I thank all of you lovable coconuts for being here because we couldn't do it without you.
I've never been called a coconut.
You are a coconut. At this moment, while this, you know, we tape these shows in advance. And Kay Stevens, where are you appearing at?
El San Juan Hotel in San Juan, Puerto Rico. Oh, I love it.
You're going to be there for a week or two?
Romance, 10 days. And I have a friend there, his name is Zizo.
She has a friend everywhere she goes.
They're all your old friends, my dear.
That'll be enough of that, ladies and gentlemen. You have a comment you'd like to make, Richard?
To mention, as we are taping ahead, when this show is being seen,
yes.
I'll be at Newbury's.
There. Let's say hello to our two players, Susie Backus and Ronnie Schwartz. Hello, ladies.
Hello.
Those of you who were with us last time will remember that this game ended in a tie, didn't it?
Yes, it did.
And now we're going to go to a tiebreaker. So, we'll go to a tiebreaker and explain how the rules go and all that right after we go to this commercial. Let's get that out of the way, then. Come right back. Hello there. Listen, I just forgot to mention that this lady, of course, is our current champ. She's won $2,850. A lot of money. And she was challenged by Susie, and Susie did tie her. So the game ended in a tie, and we'll wipe the slate clean and push the button here and reveal two tiebreaker questions. One question for each of you. The one who has scored the most will be the winner. And Susie, as a challenger, we ask you to make a selection.
I will stick with B.
B, she says, was good to her last time. She thinks it'll be good to her this time. Everyone participates.
I love it when you say everyone participates. I get very nervous when you say everybody lays out.
Nobody lays out in this question.
Okay.
Confucius say, a true friend as someone who blanks you when you have a cold. Confucius say, a true friend is someone who blanks you or branks you when you have a cold.
I like branks.
Someone who branks you when you have a cold is a true friend, according to Confucius.
You're putting us on.
No, I won't put you on.
Okay.
Okay, everybody finish over here. What do you say, Susie? Confucius say a true friend is someone who branks you when you have a cold. What do you say to that?
I'll say kisses.
Kisses you when you have a cold. I hear Confucius was a very good kisser. What do you say?
He was terrific.
Terrific.
And as you were going over there, I said, I want to change mine, and I wrote a change. And Brett said, you can't do that. They'll say you cheated.
Well, no, if you change your answer before she give her answer, it's okay. But if you change your answer after she give her answer, that's a no good.
Oh, no. That's no good. A man who change answer after answer give him big
That's right.
First time.
You just undo all the good Richard Nixon do by going to China.
That's a shame. See, first thing I thought was going to be very funny if I take this one and say, everybody rubs you.
Everybody rubs you when you have a cold.
But I change it up.
Yeah?
Before she say anything at all.
Now, what do you change
to? I thought it was going to be kisses.
Kisses. Yeah. How do you say that? Okay.
Never lied to
He's never lied to us before. As Richard has pointed out, he's an honest man, and so he did give his answer before she said kisses, and that's one match. Now, Brett, what do you say?
I say I had the best nap I've had all week.
I thought it was pretty good, and I was going to ask you to go into a vaudeville act with me there.
And I forgot the damn question. Now, what happened?
Confused to say a true friend is someone who branks you when you have a cold.
Cuddles.
Cuddles you.
Yeah.
Ah, but that cuddle is not kissing.
Now, you can see, that man who does that bloody buzzer, he wouldn't cuddle anybody when they had a cold.
What do
Charles,
you hear?
Do you kiss or cuddle when someone has a cold?
I saw a bad Chinese act read. I just simply wrote kisses.
Kisses. Well, another match for Susie. Okay, Elaine.
Yes. Everyone kisses when they have
kisses
a cold.
Kisses when you have a cold. Okay. What about you, Fu Manchu?
Only thing of kissing Chinese person. 1 hour later, you won't kiss.
Okay. All right, Kay, it's up to you.
I know.
You what like kissing.
What does the depressed personality
but
say?
But I think fondle. I didn't know how to spell fondle, so I wrote kisses.
I see. Fine for you. Fine. Now, Ronnie, we've got a question for you. Listen carefully. You've got to go some 5 to tie. Yes. 6, however, will win the game. Here it is, folks, for everyone. Lola put this ad in the paper. For sale, cheap. One bra, only slightly blanked.
I know it well.
Lola,
I don't know, I get up every morning
sale,
and I
cheap.
Do this. I don't have anything here, but I got the thickest wrist you ever saw.
Three there? Are you ready?
Everybody
there?
In town knows
okay.
you.
Now, Ronnie, Lola put this ad in the paper. For sale, cheap. One bra, only slightly blanked.
Used.
Yeah. Used. The audience is yaying her. I guess they agree with her. Larry, what say you to this?
What does he know about bras?
I don't know.
He wears them all the time.
He doesn't wear them.
Not all the time. They're only slightly used.
Slightly used. So there's one match. And Brett?
I thought I wasn't going to be able to finish my Baby Ruth before you got to me, but I did.
You did.
What did I say? Well, I said used.
Used? Okay, that's her answer. That's 2 for you. Charles.
Gioni, it's true. Just once on Sunday and then just around the block.
I see. Okay, the question, for sale cheap, one bra, only slightly blanked. And you wrote...
Well, if they knew anything about women, slightly burned.
Slightly burned.
Good answer, Elaine.
All right,
I think I've hated you all week long.
Two main celebrities to stay in the game. Mr. Dawson, you will...
Say slightly burned.
Only slightly.
Sunny side up, of course.
Now, Ronnie, you need one more to stay in the game and achieve a tie. Let's see if it happens.
Yeah. I took one look at that gardenia. I like that lady used.
Yeah, that's how you. Well, just luck.
Tie-breaker.
We gotta go to a tie-breaker. But first, we gotta go to the commercial, and then we go to the tie-breaker.
Tune in, turn on, and blank out. With that.
All right. Okay. This, I think, has happened only once before where we've had to go to a tiebreaker 2 times. So let's wipe the slate clean again, eliminate those 2 fives, press the button, and nothing happens. There
it is. Darling, it's the story of my life.
Please to have out with my husband all the time.
Another tiebreaker here. Susie, the challenger, would you please make a selection?
Good old B.
Good old B is what she wants, and this is what we have for you this time. The hillbilly's wife said, Zeke, I am now a liberated woman. You do the housework, and I'll blank. That's what the hillbilly's wife said. I am now a liberated woman. You do the housework, and I'll blank. Okay, already down here? Charles is about ready now. And we'll call on Susie. The hillbilly's wife said, Zeke, I am now a liberated woman. You do the housework and I'll...
do the working.
Go to work or do the work? Okay. So they're gonna switch. You mean she'll take his job? Is that what you mean? Or she'll go to work and he'll do the housework. That's whatever her answer is. And what do you say there?
That's whatever her answer is.
What does that mean? I don't know what it means.
That means that she's got one right, because she went out to work the still.
Work the still. How about that? No?
The word work is in it.
Well, no, they say you have named a specific job.
All right, work the busy.
So you got a buzz on that, too.
You got nothing. Go back to
Chad. Brett, what do you say?
I think Larry Blyden's a troublemaker.
That's what you say?
Yes. I said plow the fields.
Plow the fields. Well, that's a specific job, too. She said do the working and did not specify what kind of job it was.
Well,
Charles?
She was going to make the gin.
Make the gin. Right. You know, you all kind of got the same idea that she had, but she was not specific, and you are being specific, and therefore they can't match. What do you say?
I said specific.
Okay. All right. Show us your card that says specific. Go to work as a man. Well, there's one. All right. All right.
Very good.
Yes, it was excellent,
really,
I thought.
Very, very good.
Yes.
Thank you. I need encouragement.
1 out of 4 days is not good. Well, that's good. Anybody know, you know, hillbillies never do any work anyway.
That's right.
Main thing they do is sleep, so I said the wife would do.
Yeah.
That's right.
Okay.
Richard, there's something I've been trying to tell you since you sent me those flowers a few years ago. There's something I've been trying to tell you, Richard.
What is that?
It's sleep.
Sleep. Yeah. So you matched one celebrity, Susie, and now let's see how Ronnie does with hers. You need one to tie Ronnie. Two will win another game for you, and that'll be your second game. Liz said to her husband, I know Ralph is your best army buddy, but does he have to blank with us? Liz said that to her husband.
We know.
Oh. Okay. Upper tier is ready.
Upper tier.
Upper tier here. Come along and lay.
What was that?
The lounge is ready.
The lower tier is ready. Now, Ronnie, we need a response from you. I know Ralph is your best army buddy, but does he have to...
sleep.
She said sleep.
And why not?
Sleep is your answer. Sleep. One more, and you win the game.
Well, I'm sick and tired of being the villain. And all that stuff, and my life is over. But I said sleep in.
So that wins the game. Congratulations, Ronnie. Another 100 for you. Stand by for a moment. Sleep, sleep. It was sleep all the way around. Sleep, that was a great old song. Susie, it's been a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you. I had a good time.
Well, I'm glad you did. We've got a gift for you, and many thanks for being with us on Match Game 74. Susie Backer. Goodbye, Susie. We'll come back to this lady and see how she does with the big super match right after this message. This lady is getting to be a veteran, aren't you?
Yes, I love it.
Second time around up here.
Yes.
You know how it goes?
I hope so.
Shall we begin?
Yes, let's.
Here we go. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. fifth blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. The second, $250, and the third, $100. Now, which celebrities would you like to get a little help from?
Chuck?
Chuck.
Yes?
No, he's Chuck.
Oh, I'm sorry.
You're not Chuck. He is Chuck up there.
Oh, your name's Elaine.
Thank you, Brett.
The butchie right. guy up there. What do you say, Chuck?
Dimension.
Fifth dimension. All right, there's one for you.
Dickie?
Whom did you call her?
Richard.
Oh, first you said
you called him Dickie yesterday.
And now Richard, what do you say?
Dickie. Fifth Dickie. Avenue.
Fifth Avenue.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Larry?
Fifth Amendment.
Fifth Amendment.
Oh.
A timely answer. Okay. So you've got Fifth Avenue, Fifth Dimension, and Fifth Amendment. You may choose one of those as your answer or think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
I think I'll try Fifth Avenue.
We'll try Fifth Avenue. All right, we all hope it's up there. It's the one that Dickie gave you.
Thank you, Jeannie.
We Dickie are looking who? For Fifth Avenue. May we see the $100 response? Fifth Amendment.
Oh,
that's Larry's.
Good.
That's up there. That may be a good omen for you, Ronnie. Who knows? Still looking for Fifth Avenue. Here's a $250 response. Fifth Dimension.
Oh,
okay.
Oh,
so two out of three so far are up there. Let's find out now what is under that $500 response. Fifth Avenue.
All right. I want some of those gardenias. That's all I can say.
Yeah, that gardenia has really
good
brought
luck.
You good luck, hasn't it? It's a fresh gardenia, and she's carried it with her every second of the time. Now, you've won the $500. That means you'll be playing for 10 times that amount, or, bing, $5,000. Now, to collect, remember, you got to match one of the dingbats head-to-head. Has to be an exact match. Which one would you like to lock horns with?
Richard, please.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. You're going to face me. And here is the $5,000 question. Blank night. N-I-G-H-T. Blank night. Or blank night.
Spell the night for me.
N-I-G-H-T.
That comes.
You lay them, I'll sell them.
Okay, he's finished. Now, Ronnie, we need a response from you. How do you fill in that blank? Blank night.
Silent Yay! Night.
Silent night. Would you
Call
have said
yourself,
that?
Kay.
We don't know what Richard has said until he has shown us his card. For $5,000, would you show us your card?
No.
Would you
well,
do it?
Here's $6,000.
Would you do it for 20 cents?
20 cents. Well, you're a nice person.
Okay.
Well, the reason the knight, the spelling was because I told the white knight on Ajax.
Yes.
I know you're going to hate me, but don't blame me. Blame your gardenia.
$8,450. How do you feel?
I feel $8,450 richer.
That's okay. Well, you're going to meet another player and play another game, and you may be richer than $8,450. We'll find out. Here comes Gary Kraber.
Fine, nervous.
Are you nervous?
A little bit.
Take a deep breath. Attaboy. See? You are now not nervous.
Thank you.
Okay, Gary, where are you from and all that?
Newbury Park. I married to my wife, Linda, which is nice.
Where is she?
She's that pretty blonde lady.
Yeah. Let's get a picture of the pretty blonde lady
the
out
white
there,
sweater there
with the white turtleneck sweater and the rest of it. Okay, Linda will be rooting for you. And what do you do?
I'm a life insurance salesman.
Okay, good luck to you, Gary, and good luck to you, Ronnie. We will start this game right after we pass along a message or two to you.
GSN presents Behind the Blank. Match Game was a hit show from 73 to 78. This hit game show won blank number of daytime Emmys. Was it 5, 4, a mere 3, or none? Stay tuned for the answer. Do you know how many Emmys Match Game won? The correct answer is D, 0. Match Game received top ratings but was snubbed by the Emmys. It may remain without a statue, but not without stature. Stay tuned for more of that 70s Hour on GSN.
We're going to have to start this game next time because our time is just about up for today. I want to thank you and look forward to seeing you next time. And you too, lovely people.
Charles is reading the paper.
You've had your go at Tattletales, and immediately following this show on Tattletale, you'll see such people as Orson Bean and his wife Carolyn, and Bert Convy, of course, is a splendid host of that show. There's a lot of excitement, and you'll want to be sure to stay tuned for Tattletales. This is Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are the InSinkErator hot water dispenser. It gives you 190-degree water at your kitchen sink like having a tea kettle always ready from InSinkErator. And AstroTurf Doormat, the fresh new way to say welcome, combines beauty, durability, and charm. AstroTurf Doormat for all seasons from Monsanto. And a supply of Airwick Solid, including rose, natural, and lemon scents. In beautiful decorated colors, Airwick works 24 hours a day to help eliminate odor. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Topman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.